Okay, we are back for game two. And we see GOAT, interesting heat team on Empo's side. The CGI plus Mark plus trapping. On Flaming Teeny side, we see Zyranja, which is kind of good mon at the moment because Latios is rising in usage. So I assume this is gonna be a Zard Y because he's a doggy to trip the opposing Toxapex. I mean, can also be Zard X because like doggy gets rid of Heatran, but Heatran isn't even the best Zard X check to be honest. Empo's team is interesting. I don't understand the entire purpose of it yet. But yeah, Effie is Banta, I assume he's gonna go for Pursuit and he kills the Zard turn 1 and now he's gonna get revenge by Dagi. Oh my lord, gone turn 1. I can't even give my narration thoughts. This guy just going in, Z-move Dagi, picking off the Tita. Kill for kill, trap, trap, Banta picking off the Zard, Dagi picking up the Tita, Lando throwing up the rocks for Flame Victini. As it's a smack, oh not smackdown, it's a gravity Landris. So something's getting an earthquake, which is the Sidurai, the flying resist. The ground resist, what am I saying? But he throws up the rocks, predicting the Sidurai to come in. Dude, I'm wondering if this is like, if this Zard is like... Okay, well, it's the defog to Sidurai, yeah, it's obvious. I thought it could be defog's gone too, maybe it's double defog? But I was thinking, because he has a doggy to get rid of trends, maybe this is FD pass into Zard or something if it's Zard X, but we'll never know. I think it was Zard Y. He traps the Ferrothorn, so he has a trapper set. All this Ferrothorn can do is get up layers. It's just getting beat down. Okay, it has knockoff, so it's able to touch the Decidueye at least. But the Decidueye will probably carry Roost. So this Decidueye beats the Ferrothorn 1v1. So this is a pretty interesting team by Empo. It's like double trappers, but it's triple trappers. He has Spirit Shackle on the Decidueye, he has a Pursuit on Mark, and he has this Dagi. That's a really interesting concept, and this Decidueye beats the Ferrothorn 1v1, it's like really cool. He's gonna roost up here. Slowly but surely, Effie's Ferrothorn is getting beat down. And this is game 2 by the way, so if Empo wins, he is... Yeah, Empo won game 1. Like, sometimes I try to avoid spoiling the last game if you haven't seen it yet, but like, I don't really care anymore. Like, you guys can go check the Black Red game if you wanna. If you don't wanna, just let it be, it's whatever. Like, I mean, obviously, would like if you check out all my videos, but it's up to you. Obviously, I don't know what I'm even saying here. But yeah, this is just Flame BT trying to get up some hazards, but the Decidueye I can roost and then it can default. Like, now we get up all three layers, so I think it's a perfect time to defog. At least, okay, last time he didn't defog, but now it would be time to defog for Ample. He doesn't want to defog, which is interesting. Because if he defogged, there would have been, like, at least one or two layers less of spikes. The Pharaoh. Yeah, okay, yeah, he could have roosted too. Like, he said Dirts or something. Or Oblivion said that, but then he roosted one more time. That was kind of weird. But the type of Lily has no good switch-ins. If it's Death Scum, that can potentially switch in, but not if it's Specs Lily. Yeah, so looking at Flame Victini's team, that's probably Scarf Killed. We saw Rocks Lander, right? We saw Spikes Pharaoh. So it's either Z-move Midjourna or Z-move Tapu Lily. On the Empo side, we already saw the Z-move. So I assume that Specs as the Decidueye just dies. If he roosted on the Pharaoh, at least he could have defogged. That was weird. Like, couldn't he have stalled out the Pharaoh out of knockoffs and been at like full with his Decidueye? I know it would have taken forever. It has a good chunk. If that's AV Muck, I think that's Specs later. Yep, there we see the Specs. And the Mug is not getting 2 hit KO thanks to getting rid of the Spags, and the Pursuit does pick off the Tapu Lele. And the Majuna is potentially gonna shift gear up here. Because those spikes are actually pretty cool for Flame Victini. Because then he can, I was about to say break the Sash of Dougie, but Dougie doesn't have a Sash. So if this is the electric Z-move Majuna, I think Flame Victini wins this game. He could also just be a regular T-Bolt and have a different Z-move. But I think Bolt Beam Majuna has like been used lately. It's kind of cool. Yeah, I love this game. It's like so fast, like, and they just have such cool teams. Especially Ember's team looks so cool, and he does sack on the Gigavolt Havoc. He does sack the Mach to Hazards. So this might have whirlwind the Skarmory to get rid of the boosts, as he does get paralyzed, but he doesn't get fully parried. Full parried, that would have been game over. But Akelius is gonna go for Scald here. Trying to get a burn on the Toxapex. If he has Scald, some Keldeos run Surf on Scarf. Yeah, Solhard is really busted. The chat is talking about it. When something dies, it gets a boost, even though if you don't kill it, if it dies to Hazards. But he does just try to burn the Toxapex and doesn't get it. As we see, it is eject button packs. That doesn't really do anything for Empo. He's just gonna go back to it. And this time, Flame Victini gets the burn. And he's just gonna go into Majuna here, and he's probably gonna shift gear up because he doesn't want the Dougie to come and trap him, exactly. And he cannot avoid the burn. That burn is kind of big for Empo. And Empo's just gonna spin recover here, yep. So if Flame Victini has to like get a crit or something, he has Calm Mind, he's that sad. I don't know if he's Calm Mind Bolt Beam or if he's like Corkscrew Crash. My lord, yeah, I think this Majuna just wins. Wait, does he have haste? Oh, he has haste, never mind. Yeah, he has haste. I forgot about haste. Toxapex, that's one of the reasons why Toxapex is not bad. Like, Toxapex is passive as Slip, but if it didn't have haste, it would be so bad. But like, haste, because it would be set up for it, for like, stuff like Zard. But yeah, he just traps this with a Dougie. Did I say Empo wins? No, Empo loses, dude. Yeah, Landorus just clicks off quick here. The Dougie can get out of a Toxic or some chip damage. Empo just forfeits. I don't know. Did I say Empo wins? Dude, I'm so confused. This game was so fast. But yeah, Flame Victini takes Sun and Moon, and we're gonna be back with Auras. And that's gonna be the all-deciding game. They already started, so stay tuned for that.